4-0 up in their derby, their classicer at home.
Just try to make sure they are in the Europa League. They need to at least match Apoel's results pressure and had pointed answers to questions, including about this man, Cristiano Ronaldo, yesterday. Group stage irregular in the Europa League knockouts. Has reffed both Dortmund and Real Madrid previously. And Real Madrid, and here's the Real Madrid lineup.
Now we'll see if Zinedine Zidane plays with a 4-4-2 or a 4-3-3. No more different questions. Nacho comes in at right back. Isco, Casemiro, Kovacic in midfield. And then up front, Ronaldo tilted to the left side and Lucas Vazquez on the right. Now those might interchange. We might see Vazquez come out to the left with Isco on the right. And we'll see how that one looks in the first 5 or 10 minutes of this game.
Still no Gareth Bale over the last 5 seasons for Borussia Dortmund. You could put a great team out there of players who are injured right now. Here's who is available.
And they have it listed as a 3-5-2. I think this will look more like a 4-3-3 with Bartra playing as a right back, Sokratis and Subotic in the middle, Schmelzer on the left. Shaheem will sit a little bit deeper behind Dahoud and Guerrero, who will play further forward, maybe a little bit more inside. The front three, I expect, to remain the same. Kagawa on the left.
Needed to make sure they better Apoel's result and have games in the spring. Underway, final day of the group stage. Hernandez just goes by that first name for Ronaldo. Fell back to his feet, popped up in the air, and okay, able to come. There's Ronaldo running at Mark Bartra. Ronaldo driving inside, slipping it in. Isco, it's going to fall to the near side of the opening goal. Borja Mayoral, his first career Champions League start. 20-year-old Madrid native. Giving Real the opening goal 8 minutes in. Second goal in 20 matches for his hometown club.
And it was Dortmund caught in transition. And it starts with Cristiano Ronaldo. We saw that positive run he had a couple minutes ago.
Ronaldo will continue to chase, and Keylor Navas is starting his third straight game since an injury playing for Costa Rica in October. Just a bit overcooked for Mayoral, held in by Kovacic. Ronaldo once again looking to pop up and curl a shot in. My goodness! Cristiano Ronaldo, first player in history to score in all 6 games of a Champions League group stage. This could get really ugly for Borussia Dortmund.
His 9th goal in the Champions League this season. And he's been looking for it all game. He had the early shot that Berkey made the save on. He had the second one where he brings it inside and lays off an assist to the back post. And then this one, he's just looking for it. It's a half yard.
Pulisic keeps it in play, circling around Teo. Here comes Christian Pulisic looking to roll it in front. A touch from Varane. Very dangerously as it beat Navas, is going to end in behind for a corner. Good moment from Borussia Dortmund. Ronaldo, Casemiro, Berkey gets there just in time.
I think that went out.
Pulisic pass one, Pulisic pass two, Pulisic pass three. Now in for Kagawa, pings around. Bartra in for Aubameyang, takes the touch and pulls it wide. Navas was scrambling out.
That's two good chances they've had, John. The first one from Kagawa as he runs through the middle, and then this one from Aubameyang. Sergio Ramos comes out of the hole.
Reshuffle the pack a bit here. Ramos back in front by Vazquez, knocked down by Subotic. He's played just about every position on the field. Here's Teo coming forward, cutting it back for Ronaldo. A little bit of a bump there from Schmelzer. Kralovets, the referee, and he's just returning. Missed the last 5 games with injury. Schmelzer stepping up to win it away. Early cross, Aubameyang, lovely header. Lovely goal for Dortmund. Making what could have been a really nasty first half of the Bernabeu look a fair bit better.
And there he is, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, making amends for that earlier miss. And it's excellent work from Schmelzer. He steps in front. Now Asensio's caught backpedaling here. Ball's a little bit in no man's land. He steps through, recognizes it, and then the early cross, it's so hard to defend, and he's onside.
Teo for Isco. The return cross, Mayoral just put it wide. Pulisic waiting for more support. Pulisic trying to cut around Sergio Ramos. A little bit of touch there from Teo tracking back. As we've seen, it's going to take a shadowing as well. Shaheen Kagawa, a lovely touch. Aubameyang is onside. Navas makes the save. It's like the whole play stopped, and Aubameyang puts it in. Everyone in Real Madrid stopped. Aubameyang kept playing. His second goal. Goals either side of halftime, and for a second consecutive season, the Champions League, Dortmund have wiped away a two-goal deficit to get back on level terms with Real Madrid.
Well, everyone thought this was offside, and we'll get a look on the replay.
Rare miss for the best goal scorer in the history of this competition.
He almost shut me right up. It was a poor giveaway, though, from Dahoud in midfield. You cannot afford to do this.
An early outlet for Aubameyang. Nacho running with him. Aubameyang trying to run past him. It's a very narrow angle. Nacho getting a block. Archer again called in to defend. Cristiano Ronaldo dances right around him. Asensio this time to play in the outswinger. Samara up. Ronaldo on the doorstep. And that one is going to be waved off. And this is where it's tough. Without video review, you've got three referees. They're trying to piece it back together, the exact sequence of who touched the ball, when, who was in what position, to make sure they have the call correct. Well, waiting for it, elects to punch. Teo hit off the ball and in for a goal, and a wonderful goal for Real Madrid from Lucas Vazquez, limping earlier, putting Real Madrid in the lead now with 10 minutes to go.
You could just feel it coming. The pressure for the past 10, 15 minutes. Dortmund unable to get out of their own end. String passes together. The pressure from Real.